Hi there. In this video, we'll be talking about different resources for you to download fonts from, so let's get started. The first one in the list is font.adobe.com. This works particularly well if you have the Adobe Cloud version, so let's type in Museo Sans and hit enter. You'll land on this screen where it populates the Museo Sans family with 37 variations in it. You could also see that it gives me the option to deactivate all 37 fonts, which means I already have all of them activated and installed on my computer. I'm going to go back and type in another font name here, so let's type in Bungie and hit enter. Now let's click the one on the left with 5 fonts within the family. Now I have the option of individually activating the font by just clicking this slider, or have all the fonts within the family activated, in which case I'll have to click this slider at the top right. Let's just activate all of them. Let's go to InDesign and grab the type tool and make a text box. Let's type in something and increase the font size to 24 points. Let's change the font to Bungie. And the moment you type in the name, you'll find all the variations populating. So let's click Bungie Outline and voila, that's your font activated in a jiffy. No hassles of individually installing fonts, just one click to activate and the entire font family is there in InDesign at your service. Let me show you another powerful feature of this website. Now suppose you have a screenshot of a font, but you don't know which font it is. So you see this camera icon. When you hover your cursor over it, it says upload a photo to scan for similar type. Click it and it will ask you to upload the screenshot. So locate the screenshot on the computer and hit open. At this point, it will scan the screenshot and it will take a few seconds and bring you to this screen. My screenshot had 2 lines which confused the website. So it is asking to select a single line of text. So using the anchor points, select a line from the sample and click the next step button. Now it wants to verify once again to ensure that the text is actually what the website thinks it is. This happens particularly with very stylish fonts that the website is not able to pick the right letters off, which is why this extra step. But since our scanned text and the resultant text are same, all we need to do is click the next step button. And we shall be introduced to this screen, where the website gives us various options. It does not just give us the exact font name, but also other fonts that it thinks are similar to the scanned text. Since the first font, which is Cortado Regular, matches the scanned font, I'm going to activate it. Now let's go to InDesign and select our text and change the font to Cortado Regular. And it's changed. So you see how easy and well coordinated this website is with the Adobe applications, making lives simpler and efficient. Let's move on to another popular website for fonts, and you get to install free fonts from here. It is fonts.google.com. You might not find all fonts that are there in fonts.adobe.com, but it does offer quite a lot of fonts and they are free to use. Let's type in the font Railway. And then select this one on the left. On the top bar, you can even type in your text to check out the sample and all the variations. You can even increase or decrease the point size to see how they look in them. To download the entire family, click the Download Family button on top. Else, click Select this style option to download anyone's style. It even gives you the option to embed the font, but since we don't want to embed it, let's click Download All and it shall be downloaded in zip format. Click it to extract the fonts and you shall find that the style we've chosen has 2 variations in the TTF format. Double-click it and click Install Font and it shall be installed. Do the same for the other variation as well. It's always good practice to read the licensing information. If you go down the text, you'll find it here. So this one can be used in your products or projects commercially as well. But the owner doesn't expect you to resell it, which is pretty justifiable. So if you go back to Google Fonts, you'll find a few options you can try to zero in on a font. If you go to Categories, you'll find it has all these options. So if I'm looking for a serif font, I'd uncheck the rest and it shall show me only serif fonts, making it easier for me to pick and choose. You can even choose the fonts based on thickness or slant or width. So if I check the thickness option, it shows me a variety of fonts with a set thickness as per the slider here. Checking the slant option shows me the italics fonts, and same goes for width as well. So it makes it easy for you to make your selection, particularly if you know what you're looking for. So let's move on to the last website for free fonts. It's What the Font website. And you can find the exact link to this website here. You need to subscribe to this website to download the free fonts. This website has both free and paid fonts. So if you click this button, you'll find the free fonts option sitting here. So select it and click the search button, and you shall find the options populating. Click on any one and it shall further populate the variations. And you can see that all the fonts are available for $0, which means they are free. To download, click the Buying Choices button to the right and it shall bring you to this screen. Select the desktop version and click the Add to Cart option and then hit Checkout, and you shall be able to download it from this screen. Like I mentioned earlier, you need to subscribe to this website to download the free fonts. So once you register, you can just log in using your username and password and you shall be able to download the fonts. There are other websites as well that offer free fonts, but the ones I shared today are by far the best options. So do try them and enhance your creativity. All right, guys, that concludes our session and it's time for a short break. So I'm going to see you in the next one in just a bit. Goodbye.